Bruce Fein is a constitutional lawyer. He says this issue and the Supreme Court ruling all go back to the wording of the amendment.
Anyone born in the United States and subject to the jurisdiction is automatically a citizen at birth. And if you're here and you're born a citizen, even if your parents are here without proper documentation, you're still subject to the jurisdiction of the United States. If you commit a crime, you can be prosecuted, you can be drafted into the army. If you have to pay taxes, you got to pay taxes. No one thinks that any of these babies are somehow outside the jurisdiction of the United States. The one exception that was acknowledged in law is that if you're the child of a foreign diplomat, because it's viewed that the premises of the foreign, the embassy or consulate is actually the sovereignty of the country that's sending that diplomat, then you are not subject to the jurisdiction of the United States, just like the diplomat themselves.
So when the U.S. president says, I can just sign a document, executive order, boom, it's gone, what was your reaction?
It's purely political. It's simply a mechanism to incite his base.
You see this as him drumming up his support, getting people out to vote for the midterm elections. So do you think that this issue and the issue of the caravan simply go away? He moves on to other issues?
It will drop as like lead in water. Absolutely, he will do that, which is characteristic of Mr. Trump. He brings something up, he yells and screams at it, and then just walks away from it. And I think we'll never hear anything like this. He won't even ask Congress to pass a statute that could try to end birthright citizenship, or if he really cared, even propose a constitutional amendment. Because you remember, even if he says he can do it by executive order, it doesn't preclude him politically from asking for an amendment. Even if it doesn't go anyplace, it would show that it's a level of seriousness. Because you could change the rule by an amendment to the Constitution. He hasn't even conceived of the idea that he would draft an amendment and send it to Congress to see whether they would vote by two-thirds.
And the Republicans have held both houses during his presidency. I guess if they really wanted to move this issue as a legislative measure, they could have.
Absolutely, they could have. You need two-thirds in the House and two-thirds in the Senate. That may have been difficult, but even if you care about it politically, Mike, you at least try. You know, like they did, they repealed the Affordable Care Act 80 times in the House, even though it got killed all the time in the Senate. But here, they didn't take a vote on it in either the Senate. That not only didn't take a vote, they didn't even introduce a bill. You know how easy it is? One member can just stick it in the hopper, draft it. I've drafted probably a dozen, dozens of bills. And even if it just sits there, at least it's an optical earmark that you're serious. They haven't even done that.
Bruce, always a pleasure. Thanks so much for your insights.